Hey there, I'm Dr. Jamin Brahmbhatt. I am a urologist with Orlando Health. To get to your prostate, we have to go through the rectum, and that's why it's a digital rectal exam. We did a survey with Orlando Health several years ago, and we found that the number one reason men don't go and see their physician is because they're actually worried about the examination. And not just the examination, but they're worried about what me as a physician is going to find on the examination. So if we just focus on the guys here, let me explain to you why you should get a rectal exam. A 3-second rectal exam could mean the difference between life and death. What we're essentially doing is looking and evaluating through your rectum, your prostate, and trying to rule out whether you have a high risk of cancers within your prostate. All right, so what should you do to prepare for a rectal exam? I would say don't prepare at all. Just show up. It's the equivalent of me as a doctor checking your heart with a stethoscope, or checking your lungs, or looking into your eyes or your ears. I mean, I've had patients use every single excuse in the book. It's, I'm too hairy. Oh, I just took a poop. Or I feel like this is inappropriate. I think the anxiety that comes with the exam really leads, in my mind, really leads patients to think like this is taking forever. But I feel like, as long as the doctor is able to do a good job in kind of explaining what they're doing and taking appropriate techniques to calm the patient down, it can literally be done in 3 seconds. The prostate, as you get older, once you're past those fertility days, gets bigger and essentially becomes a nuisance. And as you can tell, as it gets bigger, it may restrict the way you pee, and it can get bigger because of normal reasons like BPH, or it can get bigger because of reasons such as prostate cancer. So how do we do an exam? What we do is we actually use the rectum as a way to get to the prostate. So what we will have the patient do is essentially get in a comfortable position. And when they're on the table, we essentially get them in a very relaxed position, bending over in such a way that their pelvis is relaxed. And then what we will do is wear a glove, put some jelly on, have the patient take a deep breath and enter the rectum right here. And then we're gonna sweep and evaluate the size of the prostate. What you're going to be feeling through the whole process is maybe some mental anxiety, but when your doctor is actually doing the exam, you may feel like, I got to go to the bathroom. And that's because, again, if you remember the anatomy, your urethra goes through your prostate. So you may feel like you have to go to the bathroom, but just remember, it's just a sensation. And the base of your palm right here is what your normal prostate should feel like. And it's nice and soft and it's gentle, and I can curve over it pretty quickly. What we're looking for as urologists are basically hard areas like the knuckles. So if I'm looking at your prostate and evaluating your prostate, if I feel these hard areas, that's what we call a nodule. And that nodule is what raises alarm in our mind for potential areas that you may have prostate cancer. By the age of 50, you should be pushing to get rectal exams if that is not something that's brought up during your annual exam. All right, so thanks for joining us here on the Taboo Topics series with Orlando Health. And I want to first say thank you, and I hope that you've learned something today and that you are no longer afraid of the words digital rectal exam, but not just the words, but actually eventually getting the exam done, especially if you're over the age of 50. I had a patient actually ask me for a rectal exam today, which was so cool. Usually patients are like, no, I don't want one. But he said he remembered that I told him why it's important to get a rectal exam. And we used to do it. And today I just forgot that this was the time for his rectal exam. So he remembered, he's like, doc, you told me I need to do it every single year. So I'm going to do it. And it's really not that bad. And so you can see the importance of once you explain it to these patients, it's, you know, they're going to be much more comfortable asking for it and getting it done. So I think it's important that it's really not that bad. And this was a young patient too.